Guys, today I'm gonna reveal one of the biggest myths I see in tennis, and I'm gonna show you exactly how you're gonna be able to swing faster and gain more control at the same time. So, I see that one of the biggest mistakes that I see in most amateur tennis players is that they think that the lower they swing, the slower they swing, the more control they are gonna gain into a ball. What if I tell you that it's the completely opposite? The slower you swing, the more you're gonna lose the control with the ball. Well, if you see most professional tennis players, which are the most consistent tennis players in the world, they swing every ball really fast. So how are they able to swing super fast and still make every single ball in? I'll tell you why. They transfer the speed of their swing to get more topspin and make way more balls in. Now, what happens with most amateur players? They think that by slowing down the swing, they're gonna make more balls in. But the opposite thing happens. They slow down their swing, all the time that all those balls that are slightly going in are gonna start going out because that ball's not getting enough spin. So, next time you go into the court, instead of thinking about like, okay, I'm trying to make more balls in, what should I do this time? Instead of thinking about slowing down, think about, okay, I'm gonna start swinging the same way, but maybe instead of trying to hit super hard, let's say you have a pretty low swing, okay? Let's say you're hitting hard, but you're hitting a little flat this way. Focus on swinging the racket the same way, but this time getting a little more spin. So instead of hitting flat this way, okay, that ball went slightly out, right? I'm gonna swing with the same speed, but this time I'm gonna focus on getting more spin on the ball, swinging the same way. So I'm here, so my racket went with the same speed, even more, but this time I made that ball in. Why? Because all that racket head speed is going towards spin on the ball instead of pace, which is the most important thing. Same on absolutely every shot, okay? Let's say, for example, you wanna hit that backhand and you wanna make it in. I see so many players, when they start trying to make that backhand in, they slow down, they start bringing the elbows here, and all of a sudden, they hit opening up, right? They are here, they bring the elbows, and they start doing this, right? Of course, even if you make that ball, that's not a good ball that you're not gonna win matches with. Instead of doing that thing like, okay, I'm missing a few balls out, what can I do? Keep doing a big follow through, keep doing everything right, but this time we're gonna focus on getting a little more spin. So I'm here, I'm gonna transfer all the spin, and all of a sudden, that same backhand turns into a much better backhand instead of the other one. Now you're gonna be asking me, it's like, okay, Aritz, but what's the right amount of speed that I wanna get into my racket so I get the full amount of control? Now the right answer is somewhere between the 70 and 80-85% of full speed of your racket. I know it might seem a little bit high, 70 or 80%, but that's the right amount of speed that you want on your racket to get the full control, okay? And it has been proven with pros and amateur players and all kinds of players, okay? Anything lower than 70 is gonna make you lose control. Anything higher, of course, is gonna make you lose control. You're gonna get more pace, but you're gonna also lose control at the same time. Now, how can you practice this? I'm gonna give you a very good drill that I use all the time with my students, so you start learning what's the full speed of your shots and what's the right amount of speed that you wanna get into the racket between that 70 and 85%. So it's a very simple drill. You don't need a coach, the only thing you need is a few balls. So what we're gonna do is, it's gonna be a drill where you're gonna progressively hit the ball harder. So the first thing you're gonna do is, you're gonna start hitting the ball at your 50%, okay? Of course, we're not gonna start with 0% because that could mean no movement at all, okay? So we're gonna start with 50%. So for example, for me, my 50% of the forehand might be something like this, okay? Just a simple forehand with not much space, just a little bit of spin, not much. You can see how the ball is going slightly out, okay? I'm not getting enough spin, okay? So just do a few reps of that one. Now I'm gonna go to my 60%, okay? Somewhere, it's a little bit lower than my regular, than my average rallies when I'm playing a match, okay? So my 60% might be something like this. Okay, maybe a little bit harder than that here. Probably more like that one. That's pretty much like 60% here. That sounds like 60%, okay? That's my personal 60%. Might not be yours. Yours might be way harder than that. Maybe way lower, okay? It really depends on your technique, on your edge, on your like racket speed, strength. It depends on many variables, okay? That's why you gotta practice by yourself and find out your own rhythm. Let's go to 70, which is probably the lowest speed that I could hit on a cross court rally, let's say on a match. Okay, so it would probably be something like this. Okay, that sounds like it. Yeah, it's pretty good. Okay, that's a good ball, for example. That's my 70. Okay, maybe a little bit harder than that. It's my 70. Let's do a couple more. Okay, I'm gonna find my 70 here. That's more like my 70, yeah? Here. Yeah, that's my 70. Very good. That's the slowest that I could hit when I'm playing a match. Let's say I'm on the baseline rally. Okay, on a baseline rally. Let's go to 80%, which is getting closer to my top speed that I'm gonna hit on a rally from the baseline, okay? So if I'm at the baseline, I'm gonna hit something like this. That sounds like an 80%, okay, here? So you can see how I'm still getting a lot of control on those balls, but I'm not hitting full out, okay? I know that this rhythm I could make like almost every single ball in here. Okay, I'm getting a lot of spin on my ball here. I go down the line, very good. So you can see how I'm getting more pace, but I'm especially wearing way more topspin on those balls, okay? That's a ball that I'm gonna be able to be very aggressive when I'm rally from the baseline and get the other one out of balance. Next thing, we're gonna go to 90%, okay? Which is a ball that goes a little bit harder than my average rally from the baseline, slightly higher. Okay, here, it will probably be something like that, okay? So I'm here, it would be like that, okay? You can see how I'm still making that ball in, but if I'm playing a match and I hit consistently like that, I will probably start missing a few more balls, okay? So you might want to use this ball in some of the matches. Let's say if you're playing against a better player that knows how to handle your ball, you might want to use this ball so you can get a few more free points, okay? So we're going to hit a couple more times. Here's more my, here my 90. You see, I slightly missed that one, okay? Obviously, as you start hitting this one, you might start framing a few more balls, which is perfectly normal and means that you're not comfortable with that kind of like speed on your racket. And let's go to the last one, which is 100%. You're gonna hit your ball at full speed, okay? As hard as you can. Let's see if you can make it. So I'm gonna hit here, I'm gonna hit as hard as I can here. Very good, I'm gonna try to get more spin this time. Very nice, that's a great ball, for example, here. Okay, you can see how now my precision is lower because I'm just hitting as hard as I can. I might use this ball if I have, let's say, a very easy ball and I'm winning easy on a match and I want to just like go for a winner. Might be using these shots, but it's not the shot that I'm going to use consistently to gain control. Here. Very good. I'm going to do it again here in open stance maybe. Okay, again here. You can see how I'm making like right now about like maybe like 50% of the shots in. It's not super consistent, but of course I'm going for a winner when I'm using my 100%, okay? I'm gonna do it a couple more times here. I'm mishitting the ball a little more now. And that one. So my goal here is not to make the ball in, just to get used to what's my full speed on the racket. Make sure you warm up, you don't wanna get injured before you hit 100%, okay? But this is the best drill that you are able to do to find out that sweet spot where you're gonna be able to learn what's your 70 to 85%. Once you get that, my suggestion is go get a partner, start doing some cross court rallies and try to put that on practice. Be like, okay, this ball was 70, this was 70. Oh, this was a little bit lower. This was more like 60, I need to hit a little harder. And just by doing that, you're gonna see how your consistency improves massively. And don't forget, we're learning how to hit that ball with that racket with a lot of speed on the racket, transferring it into topspin instead of pace. That's the way you get more control when you need it, okay? So I hope this video helped you out. Don't forget, follow us on Instagram at Time Value of Tennis, okay? We're posting a lot of cool stuff right there. We're gonna soon be launching new things, so just make sure you check it out. That's the first place where we're gonna launch it, and we'll see you in the next video.